Dreams are made of leaders. Mind to disagree.
It's the Marty and Gus show.
Don't you love that song?
Welcome.
Yeah, it's a cool song.
It's got to bring back memories.
I always think of Stevie Nicks, but it's the wrong one.
Okay, now don't just turn it off. You need to, like, fade it out.
I'm not sure if I'm that confident to do that, but I'll do my best.
You can do it.
But are you got anything else to say about it?
Well, just that it was a great song. Don't you love it? She was fantastic. Weren't they brother and sister?
I don't know.
Eurythmics, I'm pretty sure they were. Maybe second cousins or something, I don't know. But Annie Lennox, she was fantastic.
Why are we thinking about Sweet Dreams? Did you have a sweet dream?
Sweet Dreams. Well, I heard this song this morning, and you mentioned the fact that you had dreams. So I'm thinking, well, that's pretty appropriate. Tell us about your dream world.
Well, all I can say to you was very sweet.
Sweet?
It was sweet, yeah, sweet. It's very nice.
Well, and more information.
I don't know how to type in a letter. Personal.
Why don't you tell me the most exotic dream you've ever had?
Actually,
involved women?
No. I was keeping
it. Then how can it be exotic?
I was sleeping. Yeah, no, it was exotic. I was keeping a bit of a sleep diary, dream diary, years ago.
Are you for real?
For real. Just because I was interested. And, anyway, but I'll tell the story. So I was keeping a bit of a sleep diary. And actually, I'd read... suggested many of you do. I think you're at some time. I don't do it anymore, but it's interesting.
I've never even heard of that. What? But I'm impressed by that.
People do keep dream diaries, but mind you, let me just preface that some more by saying that this was a number of years ago, and I as an avid reader those days, and also psychology books, I read Carl Jung's Dreaming, actually, On Dreaming. Now, there were a number of... Freud had all sorts of things about dreaming and that it would have sexual analogies.
So it does come back to sex.
No, that's Freud. Because Freud had all these... You know, people had symbology in dreams of eggs and birds and stuff, but it's not... I don't think it's quite as simple as that. So Carl Jung had a whole different theory, and his book On Dreaming talked about how... when you dream, it relates to circumstances in your life at the time. So it might be sequential, it might relate to something, but it still has a very strong bearing on that. So the one that I would share is when, if you may share this with the audience, at one stage we were, and this obviously is not the dream I had the other night, but the dream I had, and it's funny how, because I'd actually kept a dream diary, was the...
we're on the edge of our seats. Spit it out, boy.
But we were actually doing the stage play, one stage together.
Correct.
I can't remember if it was the one where I, you know, I said, walk this way.
Walk this way, sir. And I'll try it.
But it was one of those ones, but I had a dream...
Don't you love Grouch?
I had a dream that I was actually on the stage... And you could see, I could feel the stage around me, and I had strapped on me. Remember the Rambo bullets, and when he was Rambo, so I was Rambo on the stage, and I can vividly remember there was this fake track that sort of didn't have a beginning. Sorry, it had two ends of it, so it's only like a middle piece of train track. There was no train, and somehow I was performing to the audience. But that was sort of like that split second moment issue. So I remember that quite distinctly. And I wrote that down, and I kept a number of other dreams written down in the diary. And they soon stopped because I had one very interesting dream.
That's right. Spit out there.
Actually, another dream I remember that I was. When I had gone to have a shave one morning.
Well, I'm glad to.
And I started.
I was a bit worried there for a minute. What you said.
I started.
This morning
I started shaving.
I was a bit to have I started a shave.
Yeah, so I started shaving. And then I remember.
You're going to say something else.
Then I remember this dream, because that's when dreams. I started shaving again.
You know the four S's?
No, let me finish. Anyway, so I started shaving. And then I remembered the dream I had. And I was thinking, did that happen? Or was it a dream?
I love those. You can't work out if it's a dream.
And then I go, did it happen and involve a number of people on a like an old showboat, you know, the American showboat with the paddle steamer.
Yeah.
And everybody was in there. And
that was like the Mickey Mouse, first Mickey Mouse. Showboat, was Showboat Willie, was it?
Steamboat Willie.
The Steamboat.
Steamboat,
Steamboat Willie.
Steamboat Willie. And anyway, so yeah, that was a dream. So I won't elaborate any further, but yes, dreams, sweet dreams, and we've gone further than we thought on that. But any other?
Okay, let me ask you.
Why were you listening to sweet dreams?
No, no, hang on. Let me ask you a question. Have you ever dreamt about being in space?
Could have been spaced out.
No, 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 seriously.
I only dreamt about flying.
Because someone asked me that question.
Is that in space? Is flying in space?
Apparently, from what I know, and I've never dreamt about being in space. You know, you dream about flying and stuff, but usually it's, you're in the world and you're, like, you know, over land or over the sea or whatever, or even in the clouds. But I don't know anyone that's actually dreamt about being in space. Like, literally, well,
maybe,
in space.
Maybe they haven't shared such information. Maybe they didn't keep a sleep diary, a dream diary.
Who does that? I've never heard of anyone keeping a sleep diary. There's a bit of deja vu in that for some reason.
I'm not sure how that comes about. But, I suspect that many people did. But anyway, I didn't finish the story.
No, but hang on. Let me ask you this question. I understand if you were keeping a diary about your waking hours, but not your sleep.
Your waking hours are not interesting.
How do you write down?
You wake notes after you've woken and you've woken from the dream and you're getting up in the morning, you write it down.
No, I get that, but who remembers what they've really dreamt?
I remember lots of dreams.
Yeah. But have you dreamt about being in space?
I'm trying to remember if I've actually dreamt about it, because your morning hours, your hours from about 4 till 7 or whatever it is, that's when you have the most amount of REMs, which are rapid eye movements. And rapid eye movements, when somebody is in REM mode, is actually dreaming because the eyes are moving. So
why do they move?
Well, because you're in a dream state, so your eyes are moving. And that's
but
when you actually get because you're dreaming. You're in a dream state, your eyes are moving underneath.
So why aren't your hands moving?
I can't tell you that because your brain, how that works, but the reality is that when you're in a dream state, it's unlikely that you're going to move. You do might occasionally have a twitch, etc., but I'm not a professor of science about how REMs work, but most people don't. There are people that actually do sleep.
Well, it could be rapid
ear. I think you've told me his eyes, but you did tell me about some of your sleepwalking, didn't you, at one stage?
No.
But anyway, let's go back. We're on dreams.
I want to get to the bottom of it.
Yeah, but I do realise that time's ahead of us.
If we have to
check the counter. Okay. And I guess we started on dreaming and your sweet dreams.
Yeah, sweet dreams.
Which
is a great song.
It was only about my dreams. About my dreams, not your dreams. I'm not sure why it was my dreams, not yours. But anyway, is there anything else you want to say?
Well, you know, we were going to talk about mistaken conversations. There's so much to say and so little time to do it.
I'm going to wind it up for a minute and say, hey, keep watching.
Subscribe. Thumbs up. And do all that stuff.
That stuff here, winding up.